start. Now, this is the shaded region. Inside the shaded region, there are many points inside the shaded region. Each point inside the shaded region will give rise to one value of the objective function. This is the objective function. K equals to x minus 2y. I cannot draw this line because there is a value of k there, which is unknown. So I express this in terms of y equals to mx plus c. Then the y mx plus c. So I can draw the gradient. The gradient is negative half. So I look at the x-axis and y-axis. Negative half means the line is going this way, not positive half. Positive half is going the other way. And half means 1 over 2. The vertical distance is 1. The horizontal distance is 2. Now, we cannot count the distance actually. We can only count the units. So 1, 2 means 1 unit vertically, 2 units horizontally. Now in this case, the scale on the x-axis and y-axis, they are the same. So I can actually count the number of squares. By right, I should not count the square, like 1 square here, 2 squares here. I can only count 1 unit here, 2 unit here, to represent the gradient negative 1 over 2. Okay, as we know, each point in this region will give rise to one value of this objective function. Now I'm going to find the point, which point gives the maximum value for this function, and which of these points here give rise to the minimum value for this function. So first of all, I place a ruler across the plotted line. Okay, then I place the second ruler perpendicularly to the first ruler. Okay, then I slide the first ruler along the second ruler. The last point it hits is the point that gives rise to the maximum value. Now if I want to find the minimum value for the function, move down. Now the last point it hits is the point that gives rise to the minimum value. Okay, that's all.